Hi everyone, welcome to the channel. This is Amit and in this video I'll be showing how the first time username can be created by the GSTN. So I will tell you like so far what has happened. So last week I have field REG01, I created my TRN, then I created application reference number by giving the all details. It got assigned to the tax officer. He has issued the show cause notice and he asked for some of the clarifications, and then I have given the clarifications. It was accepted by the tax officer, and then what he has did, he has approved it. So I have got the mail of generation of GSTN. So I will just show you what mail I have received. So this is a mail with the subject welcome to GST family. It consists of like what ARN got created along with its date, and then the actual GSTN, the username and password. So basically this is GSTN, not the username. Now what you have to do, you have to just go to GST portal and you have to create the username. So I'll just show you the exact process. So this is GST portal. Click on login button. And then you have to go to, at the bottom you are able to see the hyperlink here. So you have to click on this here. It's clearly given that if you're logging in for first time, click here. So you can just click here. So once you click here, you can just copy your GSTN, you can enter it over here, then you can copy the password. You can't copy the password directly in this field. So what you can do, you can just create a find and then you can paste it over here. And then you can enter whatever you have copied. So it's 6DE249567. Fine, so we have copied the password. Now what we can do, we can click on the captcha 121164. Now we can click on login button. So once I click on login button, it will be asking for the new username, what you want to keep it for your future reference purpose. So let's say for me it's testing lab underscore 001. The password is okay. So I have given the password and username. Now I will click on submit button. So as soon as I click on submit button, I got the information message that username and password has been successfully created. Now you can use these credentials for logging in your GST portal. So I will use the username what I have created and the password and the captcha. Now I'll click on login button. So this, see, that's it guys. This is the actual way of creating the username. Most of the people doesn't know. They just think the mail got triggered, so that is the username, but that is no. You have to just take the GSTN password and then you have to create your username. So first I have logged in, so system is asking for a core business function. So you have to select one of the business function for which you have taken the registration. So I'm like service provider. I'll click service provider and click on submit button. That's it. Then it will be giving you the warning message to add the bank account details, because it was not mandatory at the time of filling the registration in the GSTR, this REG01 form. So if you want, you can just file it. You have to click on file amendment. And then you can click on bank details. The number of bank accounts can be as per your requirement. For as of me, like it is just one bank account. So I'll click on add button. I'll enter the account number. I'll select the type of account. It's saving account, and if you have IFSC, you can just add it over here. If you don't have, you can just click here for and select the bank. It's Kotak, state is Maharashtra, district is Nanded, Nagpur, city is Nagpur. So whatever the bank list is there, you can just select from this list and you can click on save button. Once it is saved, the complete details will be shown along with the branch and address. Now you have to attach the supporting document, which will be required for for the verification of your details. So so that the officer can approve your amendment. So what you can do, you can attach the document and you can click on save and continue button. So even in this video, the non-core amendment is also covered. Let's say you logged in, so system was asking for the bank account details. So we have went to non-core amendment, where what you can do, you can just give the details and click on save and continue button. So bank details got added over here. You can click on continue button and just save and continue. You can select the authorized signatory. You can fill the place and you can just submit by EVC or DSC. So once it is submitted, you will be getting the OTP. See, I got the even mail for a reminder for submitting the bank details as soon as I have created the user. In the draft which got created after filling the form for non-core amendment, and then this is the OTP which is required for login purpose, for filing the amendment purpose. So I will click on validate OTP. So your non-core amendment application got submitted successfully. This is a successful message, and you can just click on dashboard and you can navigate to services and you can check what is the status. So as of now, it is pending for validation. It will validate and within 10 to 15 minutes, its status will be changed and the changes made will be reflected in your profile. That's it guys, this is a non-core amendment. Even if you would want to change the phone number and email ID or authorized signatory or some other details, so you can just file the non-core amendment from registration and non-core fields. That's it. And if you want to check the profile, you can just navigate to my profile. So you'll be able to see the GSTN, legal name, the name of the trade, date of registration, and what is the status, it's active. Let's say if it is cancelled, it will be changed to cancelled. And even the place of business details, contact details, everything will be shown to you. So, and if you want to see the registration certificate, you can just directly navigate to notices and orders. Or if you want, you can just click it on my registration certificate. So it will be getting downloaded. So you can see this is REG6 for which the actual registration was done. Now you are... The successful registration has been completely done, username is completed, and you are now a taxpayer who is eligible to do the business, file the returns and everything. All details are added over here. See, you can see the additional place of business, but it's not added, so it's zero. Authorized signatory and everything is, you can see over here. So that's it guys, this was the video just to introduce you how to create the user, how to see registration certificate, how non-core amendment can be filed initially for updating the bank details. So thank you guys for watching the video. Do like and subscribe the channel for the motivation so that I can create more and more videos which will be beneficial for the taxpayers or even for the students for their education purpose. Thank you guys. Thank you.